But it's not pure, to speak, not pure tendon. A little bit tedious, no? And biceps and triceps. Carpal labial. Oh, you have a book?
Yeah, I have a book.
So I'm able to take off and to give your colleague. To put your hands like this and relax. If we beat the radial os, this part distal, we can see a little bit small, very small flexion of the arm of the arm in the arm. In the I forgot the name. Sorry. Feel a little bit fresh, okay? Relax, please. But this amplitude is very small, so sometimes patient is able to control. So sometimes it's necessary to give him some task, for example, to calculate something, to list the days of a week, the months of the year, in order to change his ability to control. Okay. Would you be so kind to repeat? January, February, loud and very quickly, okay? Do it, please. January, February, March, April, May, June, July, August, please.
January, February. Don't be happy about the day, May, June, July, August. Don't be happy about the day, May.
It's okay.
I don't know.
Arpalatal. Sedentic. Normal, okay? No spreading of areas of exacerbation. Next one, biceps. You should put the angle is approximately more than 90 degrees, 120, for example, this angle. You should put your finger to the my finger, patient, not patient, but physician finger, to the tendon of biceps, and to beat. But also he is controlling. So, in opposite side. Once again, January, February, March, okay.
Yeah, city.
A little bit flexion in the elbow. Please, January, February.
Okay.
You can see a little bit flexion, same both sides. It's called biceps. And the last part, triceps. The angle is almost the same, but it will be opposite side. The tendon of triceps. If bicep flexion, is triceps extension. It's okay. Then there will be theoretical part. So there will be question. What are the possible changes of reflexes? So you should reproduce that tendon reflexes are decreased in lower motor neuron disease and are increased in upper motor neuron disease, okay? And maybe what are the other signs of upper motor neuron disease? What are the other signs of lower motor neuron disease? So there will be one, two theoretical questions. You should list the other signs of lower motor neuron disease, like hypertrophy, hypertrophies or atrophies, fasciculations, fibrillations, or decreasing of tendon reflexes, decreasing of muscle tone, and some others, okay? If upper motor neuron disease, so increasing tendon reflexes, pathological signs, hypertrophies are serious, severe hepatomegaloid hypertrophic atrophies are not typical, not, not typical. And increased muscle tone. That's cool. Next question. On the legs a little bit later. First of all, we do it about the arms, then legs, okay? The question for variation of muscle power and tone in the arms. Of course, muscle power can be examined in all muscles, but it's not necessary. It will take a lot of time to check all muscles of the extremities. We have limited time for examination of patient. So we will check the most important main groups. We can start from distal part of it or from proximal, it doesn't matter. For distal, you can use your two fingers. You ask patient to press your fingers, physician fingers, with maximum strength. Very strong man. Try to push down, you should resist. Push down, you should. Very strong. Very strong. Please push down my. Push down my.
That's my hand?
Yeah. Flexion, a little bit flexion in the elbow. I'll try to perform extension, you should resist. Opposite. Absolutely. Very strong. It's good. And the last one, proximal. So muscle strength on the arms is very good. Next, muscle tone. Also can be checked in different joints, muscle groups. We will do it in some parts. Please relax, please maximally. No, you can sit without any. Maximum relaxation. Very good. So, normal muscle tone is characterized by the slight resistance, the same in different muscle groups. So, the same during flexion extensions should be the same. Okay? Slight resistance. There will be questions. What does it mean? Weakness in one extremity. How it's called? It's called for maybe monoparesis. If absolutely muscle power absolutely absent, plegia, monoplegia, for example. Change possible changes of muscle tone. Hypertony, hypertony. What are the what is the reason of hypertony? Hypertony. Maybe low motor neuron disease, maybe damage of cerebellum also. In case of hypertony, maybe spasticity, maybe rigidity. Plus spasticity due to the region of upper motor neuron, rigidity due to the region of basal ganglia, substantia nigra, Parkinson's disease. What are the types of, what are the signs of upper motor neuron disease, or are the types of Parkinson's disease, are the signs? So theoretical part, because you are going to become not nurses, but general practitioners.
Yes.
So you should make an interpretation of all the results. Possible, all possible changes should be discussed. Understand? Next, legs. Is it possible to lie down supine position? No, you can. If you can take off on if. Or shoes, if you do not want. It's okay. Here, head here. No, head here. Legs here. Supine. Oh, it's okay. So, question. The same.
From the beginning, it should be
like. The Patient of tender reflexes on the legs, and muscle power and tone on the legs. Reflexes. You should show how to examine two reflexes. Only two. Low extension. Knee and ankle. Knee. Would you be so kind to flex your legs in both? Both you have to flex your both. You should not look at the legs. Both. For knee reflex, you should beat this tendon between patella and tuberosus posterior, somewhere here. Of course, maybe the movement of the leg, but the most important thing, contraction of quadriceps. You should see to the quadriceps. Look here, to beat here, don't worry. Contraction. Same. Of course, you can check spreading of areas of the separation, but it's enough. So, symmetric knee reflex.
And normal.
So, ankle reflex. In such lying position, please pay attention. With my left arm or hand, I do a little bit, not flexion, but a little maybe extension, better to say. Or dorsal flexion, a little bit. So it's correct position of my left arm. Such examination is not correct. Look here. I should do it like this. Understand? Yeah. And then to beat Achille. You can see flexion. Opposite. If without this, so no reflex at all. Is it clear? Ankle. Or Achille, but mostly ankle is used. Is named. Ankle reflex. And then will be theoretical questions, possible changes of reflexes. What is hyperreflexia? What is hyper? When can we see hyper? When can we see hypo? Understand? Or not? Next. Examination of muscle strength and muscle tone on the legs. The same muscle strength. You can start from distal or from proximal, it doesn't matter. From proximal. Would you be so kind to raise your right leg up to 45 degrees, straight leg, approximately. I'll try to push down, you should resist. Oh, very good. Next leg. Very good. Would you flexion in the knee joints? Both sides, flexion. No, it's not flexion, not extension, flexion. And this also. I'll try to perform extension, you should resist. Opposite, I'll try to perform. Very strong. Straight legs, please. Dorsal flexion of foot, perform dorsal flexion. And try to resist my push my that's all concerning examination of muscle strength. Then muscle tone. Will you be so kind to resist? Not resist, so relax, so. I'll check in different muscle groups, it's usually enough. Okay. Normally, slight resistance, the same right, left side, the same during flexion, during extension. Thank you very much. Sit down, please. Is it clear about the first question?
Yes, Dr. Levy.
Sit down. What else about motor system also? Method of reviewing ataxia. We should examine the function of cerebellum. Did you repeat cerebellum? Wrong test. Finger to nose probe. Finger to finger probe. Ergodactylosis. Can I recommend you to repeat this? So, we have already finished with four questions. That's tomorrow we discuss. We will finish the system and ask you to read about cerebellum. So,